near the industrial monorail that services the spire. If it is still operational, it will be the fastest way inside.
Thank you. Hands up.
Don't shoot. I'm a pacifist.
Who are you?
I'm Theron Sedrax, obviously. Preeminent expert in exotechnology and senior design engineer for this facility.
Theron, huh? Don't you have a buddy named Theron?
Another Theron? He probably spells it the stupid way. Presumably, you're here to seize control of the facility? Or perhaps to sabotage the defensive systems?
As long as you cooperate, we won't hurt you.
A very reasonable position. I would love to make a grand speech about never giving up and choosing death over dishonor, but the truth is, the situation is out of my hands. All defensive systems, shields, anti-aircraft guns, and so on, have been transferred to the secondary control station near the top of the spire. All of this equipment is useless now. So there's really nothing to be accomplished here, and nothing I can help you with.
Commander.
Apparently the shield controls have been transferred to another control center higher up in the spire.
Is that so?
None of the computers will respond, my lord, and I'm seeing some lightsaber burns over here.
That was the Jedi, Tau Adair. She's commanding the last of the facility's guards. She severed the connection as soon as control was transferred, then headed upstairs.
Then we have our target. Commander, on Ossus, we united our strength to crush the Jedi who tried to oppose the Empire. It's time we repeated that triumph. Join me, and together we will win a victory for the Empire that will change the course of the galaxy forever.
I met this Jedi before on Mixha. I'm going to enjoy taking her down.
Good. Major, hold this position, no matter the cost.
Yes, my lord. And what about him?
He's a useful hostage. The Republic will have to hold back if their top scientists might get caught in the crossfire.
Good thinking.
I should have stayed on Nar Shaddaa.
We'll keep you covered. Good luck up there. Moving out. ready.
Hold it!
Oh, no.
Steady. Fear is a deadly weapon, but only if you let them have it.
I was hoping we'd run into each other again, Jedi.
We've got your back, Tal.
Fools. Not one of you could hope to defeat us.
You're not fighting one of us. You're fighting all of us.
Then you will all die.
Moving out.
Let's begin. Beaten. Your shipyard will be obliterated, your Republic will crumble, and your fellow Jedi will be hunted to extinction. Your destruction is inevitable.
As inevitable as gravity!
Evacuation protocols recommended.
I'm disabling the shields now.
Warning. Defensive shields have been disabled. Warning.
Raven to command. The shields are down. We're evacuating now.
All ships, target the Meridian complex. Fire!
Commander, allow me to congratulate you on a job well done. Your victory on Corellia is an incomparable testament to your value as an ally of the Empire. Rumors suggest great things are soon to come for you. Do enjoy. Any rewards are well earned.
What kind of rumors? What are you talking about?
I can say no more. Farewell, Commander.
It was skillfully done, to be sure. You truly embody the finest aspects of the Sith doctrine.
Coordination and focus gave us this victory. When we fight as one united empire, we cannot fail.
Do not forget, our unity extended beyond even our own empire. Commander, you are a welcome sight. Do join us.
With their shipyard destroyed, the Republic has already retreated from countless worlds.
We've been watching in real time. Terribly entertaining.
I will develop plans to extend our lines and claim the most valuable of these territories in a matter of weeks.
A shame that Malgus couldn't enjoy the fruits of his efforts.
His recovery will take some time, but rest assured he will return to the fold soon enough.
Wonderful.
Victory over our ancient enemies grows closer by the minute.
What is your plan moving forward?
We should speak in private, Commander. The rest of you are dismissed. Despite our victory, I find that the Dark Council is best used for administrative purposes, and not to conducting critical wartime activities. The Empire needs an organization capable of rapid, decisive action, operating outside the Dark Council's purview. A group answering directly to me. My predecessor had such a group, the Hand, though its members were insane, murderous fanatics. I will construct my own Hand, formed of the Empire's best and most loyal frontline personnel. My first choice would be to recruit the Hand's initial ranks from your alliance. To have Odessen officially join the Empire and your members become full citizens. As you would be charged with hunting down and eliminating our Empire's enemies, I can think of no better title for you than simply Hunter. Of course, you may forego all of this and maintain your alliance's independence if you choose. I would still have you working directly with my Hand rather than the Dark Council. The choice is yours. Will you return to the Empire? Or remain the Alliance Commander?
The Empire is where I belong. The Alliance will become your Hand, and I'll be your Hunter.
Excellent. I will begin the necessary preparations at once. In Malgus's absence, I will have to find another suitable liaison. I look forward to seeing the results of our new relationship. Farewell.
Care. The body count is too high.
This is war. Deaths are inevitable.
I don't believe that. Krovos made a choice. And that's the team we're on now.
Theron?
I know you didn't pull the trigger on all those civilians, but you're supporting the people who did. I want to trust you. But it doesn't seem like we can trust them.
A spy really should be more flexible. I've made arrangements for a bit of redecorating on Odessen, but it will take some time before we're issued enough banners, uniforms, and so on. But that can all wait, I suppose. I'm told there's quite a raucous party up in the officer's lounge. Would you care to be the star guest?
You go on. I'm not interested.
I'll probably pass as well, then.
Hey, thanks again for finding me that bottle.
Of course. If you need anyone to share it,
count on it. Mind if I borrow him a minute? I'll find you later. Pretty crazy stuff, huh? Osus wasn't even that long ago. We've already made it through so much. That's war, I suppose. Still, most grunts aren't lucky enough to work with the deadliest fighter in the entire galaxy. Which reminds me, congratulations, contest winner. Your prize is in the mail.
I'd like to dedicate my killing achievements to the many, many people who've tried to get in my way over the years.
Never miss an opportunity for practice. I actually came to talk about something else. Back on Corellia, I didn't actually make it out with the rest of the shuttles. Got caught under some falling debris in all the chaos. I wouldn't have made it out at all if they hadn't lent me a hand.
Who?
An old ally you never met.
You're the one who tried to kill me on Meksha.
Don't take it personally.
It was a test. Nothing more.
A test you actually passed.
What are you talking about?
I am Lord Scourge, once a loyal servant of the Empire.
Kira Carson, Jedi Knight. Not thrilled to be here.
All three of us have fought the same enemy. The former Sith Emperor, Tenebrae, Vitiate, Valkorion, whatever you wish to call him. We know he was once a part of you. And we both felt his destruction, but he has always been a master of deceit. We had to be sure that he wasn't lingering in your mind, hidden, waiting to come out only in the most dire circumstances. Now, we are sure.
If you were testing me, it must have been for a reason. A serious one to bring a Jedi here.
Strange as it might sound, we think you might be the only one who can help us.
We can't risk saying more here. Let's travel to your base on Odessen. It should be safe for us to talk there.
About what?
The final, gruesome weapon of Tenebrae.
What a mess.
I have removed all compromised components. Where shall we begin repairs?
Checking the failsafe is always first. Empress Asena had us double the explosive charges after the Osus mission. It was a real pain to hook up.
Yes, I examined the device after removing it. Highly complex.
You removed it? What are you thinking?
It was rendered inoperable due to damage. Replacement is required. Interestingly, it was the only damage not caused by crushing impacts. The exterior perimeter was actually cut by a high heat implement.
Oh no.
Give me the droid. And a ship.
Withholding vital wartime resources is a crime. Do your part to ensure victory.
medical attention. Be well.
Shooting today.
We're here. Now tell me what this is all about.
As I told you on Viking Space Dock, Tenebrae's last gruesome weapon. He sought immortality, but only his endless spite survives now. I was his most powerful servant once, his wrath. But I learned of his true nature and plotted his downfall for centuries. Ultimately, I saw what had to be done and betrayed my empire in order to destroy its creator. That is how I came to fight alongside Kira.
We fought the Emperor's servants constantly for years. We even thought we'd beaten him alongside my master. Then Yavin 4 happened. And Valkorion.
I received guidance from an old ally. Instead of seeking out our enemy in his current shell, you, as it turns out. We sought a different target. Tenebrae hid his original body where no one could harm it. As long as that body remained in stasis, the galaxy's greatest evil could never truly be killed.
Unless we destroyed Tenebrae, the fight against Valkorion would never really be over.
Since Valkorion is gone, I assume you succeeded.
We did. As we later learned, we destroyed his first body just as you purged the last vestige of his twisted spirit from your mind. That is when his final weapon was unleashed. A Sith ritual, carved into his very flesh, unleashed an ancient plague from every molecule of his decaying corpse.
We were both knocked out cold, comatose for more than a year. Satil Shan was the one who finally pulled us out of that nightmare and started a new one.
Like you, Kira and I have both been vessels for a portion of Tenebrae's power. It acted as a sort of vaccine. But Satil had no such protection, nor did any of her followers. Within days, they were all laid low, trapped in a nightmarish slumber. In helping us, they are knowingly doomed themselves.
Sith rituals of Force disease? I don't really see how I can help you with this.
You're the only one who can.
The infection is worsening. There is a darkness growing among the afflicted.
We can feel their minds connecting, communicating. We're afraid they might be merging somehow.
Merging into what? Another Valkorion? Is this plague bringing him back somehow?
It's too early to make that conclusion. Whatever it is immensely dangerous. We must stop it.
How?
We loaded Satil and all of her followers onto a transport to keep them quarantined, along with a few medroids to tend to them. The transport is programmed to fly a random course through unsettled sectors of the Outer Rim, all weeks away from civilization. I can send a signal to alter the course, bring it to another empty system that's closer so that we can meet it in a shuttle.
We board the ship and connect our minds with yours through the Force. Together, we will face this entity and purge it from existence. And if we cannot purge it, then we destroy the transport and hope we've ended the old monster's schemes forever.
This still doesn't sound like something I can help you with.
You shared your mind with the most powerful and malevolent entity the galaxy has ever known. And you managed to destroy it. Utterly.
If you can swing that, this ought to be a walk in the park. It's gonna take a while for the transport to come back into range.
Then we should stay here until it does. If you require any assistance in the meantime, don't hesitate to ask.
Not so fast. I'm not fighting the Republic or the Jedi, so if that's what you want, definitely hesitate to ask.
Ignore her. If necessary, I can slay enough of your enemies for both of us.
Ugh.
She grows on you. Eventually.
Commander, looks like our new friends from the Hand have just entered orbit. I'll get them cleared to land right away.
Hunter.
I am Darth Riffics. I believe the Empress told you to expect me.
You'll be the Hand's liaison to the rest of the Empire?
Precisely. Competition for the role was heated, as I'm sure you can imagine. I am proud to have stood above all others. I'll have my shuttle bring me to the surface directly. I always prefer speaking in person.
Face to face at last. Your hollow does you no justice, my friend.
I hope you've come for more than empty flattery.
Let's find out. Permit me to be direct. My duty as liaison is to facilitate your operations as best I can. My success is judged by your success. I will not profit from obstructing or undermining you. Much as I savor them, deception and manipulation are not among my objectives here. I will relate my Empress's desires to you and your accomplishments to her. Anything you require of the Empire's resources, I will obtain. I shall be your ally, your spokesman, and I hope your confidant. You have my vow on it.
I hope you can live up to your word. I don't take disappointment well.
Nor should you. The best deserves the best. Now, if I may impose upon you a bit more before we delve into official matters, I would love a tour of your base. The stories I've heard.
One of my people can show you around. Find me when you're ready to focus on our work.
As you wish. Your base is truly impressive. You must be very proud.
Are you ready to focus now?
Yes, let's. The destruction of the Meridian complex on Corellia continues to accelerate our war efforts. We've won decisive victories in the Bormir, Atrevis, and Anoat sectors. The Republic is reeling. Perfect conditions for the Hand to press the advantage.
Where does Asena want us to strike first?
That will come in time. For now, let's focus on logistical concerns. We are solidifying supply lines and secure communications between Odessen and the rest of Imperial space. A full detachment of Imperial troops is already en route to serve at your command. Assault troops, security personnel, patrol ships, and so on. Now then, there is one other matter that needs your attention as we spin up the Hand's day-to-day operations. I've acquired a list of priority targets for us to hunt down once the Hand is fully operational. Some of the targets are key Republic personnel, senators, military officers, and so on, while others are Imperial, traitors, failed Sith, and the like. I've taken the liberty of putting several noted bounty hunters on retainer to help bring these targets in. How shall I prioritize them?
Let them handle the renegade imps. The Hand should stay focused on the enemy.
A sensible course of action. I'll see it done. I believe that concludes our business for the day. Do you require anything else?
Any word on Darth Malgus? I haven't seen him since Corellia.
You are not alone in that. No one has seen him since the battle. It's all rather mysterious. Perhaps he was more badly injured than anyone knows. Or perhaps he's gone rogue again. But surely that's not possible.
I will not return. I will not return. I will not
Once again, your vital signs have elevated far beyond ideal values. I am concerned that these episodes pose a risk of permanent damage.
Then stop them.
I have already removed all physical modifications related to your loyalty assurance protocols. These hallucinations are the result of psychological manipulation. To correct such potent mental conditioning is beyond my program's scope of practice. Honestly, I am unaware of any technique capable of editing the pathways of your mind so extensively.
I have heard of one possibility. Set course for Dantooine.